मॉर्निंग क्लास 9th. टुडे वी विल रीड आवर 3 पोयम इन आवर 3rd पोयम इन आवर बीहाई बुक रेन ऑन द रूफ रिटन बाय कोट्स किनी. ही यूज इन दिस पोयम मिथालजिया. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मिथालजिया? मीन्स पथेटिक मूड एंड एज वेल एज द पास्ट मेमोरीज, ग्लूमी एटमोसफेयर, पास्ट मेमोरीज ही हैड यूज इन दिस पोयम. As the name suggests, rain on the roof means in this poem, the poet is talking about the rain, what he had experienced when the rain is coming from the clouds and when he heard the sound of the rain patters. So what type of feeling he had feel, that we can see in this poem. As it is a good atmosphere, it's a rainy season now, so you can better understand the feeling of the poet also. So in this poem I will discuss with you the hard words as well as the rhyme schemes as well as the figure of speech which are used in every stanza and line wise explanation. Just listen this video and watch this video very carefully and after that write the summary of that poem. Okay, let us start. I'll tell you something about Coates Kinney. Was born on 1826, okay, in New York. He had completed his law education and then he became a journalist and a poetry writer. The Rain on the Roof is the most popular poem and he died in 1904. About this poetry I'll tell you. This is a lyrical poem by Coates Kinney. In this poem the poet expresses his love for nature and praise the beauty of nature. The poet says that when the clouds filled with rain vapors floated in the sky everywhere, then the sadness weep in the rainy tears. Means here the poet compares the rainy drops with the tears. Means with this line we can understand the poet shows the gloomy atmosphere, the pathetic mood in this poem. It's very enjoyable to have a rest on our bedroom and it's very enjoyable to hear the patter sound of the rain on the shingles of the roof. This make an echo in the poet's heart. Many recollection and fancies take place in the poet's mind. In his memory, his dad mother's imagination is also take place. He feels happy at this and he again listen the pattering sound of the rain and get thrilled. So he beautifully expressed the poem expressing this rainy atmosphere. The words are magical which are used by the Coates Kinney. So let us start with the line wise and with the stanza wise. When the humid shadow hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weep in the rainy tears. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. First of all, the hard words, humid means full of moisture. As the humidity we are saying, humidity means that having the moisture, the wetness. So humid means full of moisture and the poet is talking about the dark cloud which is full of moisture. What about the hover? Hover means moving around. Like one object is there, as you can see that drone. Drone is moving around the one object, So hover is also the moving around particular object over all the starry spheres. Starry means full of stars. Starry means full of stars means this is the atmosphere the poet is describing about the night. Spheres means sky. The sky which is full of stars means at night. Melancholy means sad, gloomy, pathetic, darkness. Gently weeps in the rainy season. Bliss. Bliss means happiness. Cottage chamber means your bedroom. Chamber is a very small room which is having a one single bed. So cottage chamber is here bedroom of the poet. And patter means the sound of the rain. So now we'll see the rhyming scheme. Which kind of rhyming scheme used by the poet here? Rhyming scheme basically we can denote by the last word which is rhyming together. Okay, see hover, spheres, darkness, tears. Which two words are similar? Yes, spheres and tears. both are the similar. So the rhyming scheme is A, B, C and again B. A, B, C, B. Now see the pillow. Bad, patter, had. Bad and had is the rhyming together. A, B, C, B. D, E, F and again E. D, E, F, E. A, B, C, B, D, E, F, E. So this is the rhyme scheme. Because bad and had is similar. And here spares and tears is similar. So they are rhyming together. So now let us see the line wise explanation. What the poet is saying. When the humid shade of hoar. Means when the poet is praise the rain shower. Even before the rain actually start falling, the vapor laden cloud means the cloud which is full of moisture is moving around in the starry sky. Means the sky which is full of stars means at night the clouds, dark clouds which is about to falling the rain means which is full of vapors which is very heavy is moving around in the sky and over all the starry spheres. Means the that time the sky looks gloomy and the cloud is moving around in the starry night and it hides the lights of the stars and the melancholy darkness and that time the whole atmosphere was very sad, very gloomy, very we can say the peace, extreme peace was filled out there. Gently weeps in the rainy tears and gradually the rain was falling in the form of tears. Means here the raindrops is compared as a tears by the poet. What a bliss to press the pillow. It's a very happy time. It's a very magical moment and one feels like lying in the cozy bed hugging tightly the soft cushion pillow. It is really nice to hear the pitter-patter of the raindrops falling on the roof and lie to listen the patter of the soft rain overhead. Means it's a very happy time to listen the pattering sound of the rain. Now see the second stanza. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. And a thousand recollection weave their air thread into woof as I listen the patter of the rain upon the roof. First of all again we will see the rhyming scheme first, like here shingles, heart, fences, start. So again heart and start is again same. So A, B, C, B. Recollection, air thread, patter. No, recollection, woof, patter, roof. So woof and roof again rhyming together. So D, E, F and again E. A, B, C, B, D, E, F, E. Oh, this is the rhyme scheme. So now let us see the hard words. So first of all, tinkle. Here are so many rhyming words are used by the poet like tinkle, shingles. So tinkles means a ringing sound. It's a sound word. Tinkle, patter, these are the sound word. And shingles. Shingles is a kind of a roof, tin roof we are basically said. When the anything is dropped down on that roof and echoing sound is coming from the side, that is called the shingle roof. Echo. Echo means repeated sound. When we are echoing something that repeat again and come and we can hear that sound, that is echoing sound. Okay, recollection, here the poet is used, recollection is the past memories. Recollection means we are collecting again the things. Air thread means thread which is woven on the loop. And air thread, air ke koi thread nahi hote, nothing is there, just like a air thread. So it's a dreams, it's a fancies. So here the personification is used by the poet. Air thread means dreams. Woof means collecting together on a loom. Okay, patter means sound of the rain. So let us see the explanation, patter and all these things. So see the explanation. Every tinkle on the shingles means the soft ringing sound of each drop falling upon the roof tile goes a deep sound into the poet's heart and create an echo. Means when the raindrops are falling on the roofs, this is a shingle, means the tiling roofs, when the sound is falling on the roof, the tiling roof, then it create a very deep sound which is echoing in the poet's heart, which is create a repeating sound into the poet's heart. And a thousand dreamy fancies means, in that meanwhile, the poet's imagination begins to give birth thousands of fancies and begins weaving these dreams along with the thread of his memories from the past events. Means the poet is saying that my thousands of dreamy fancies begin when I heard the sound of the raindrops which is falling on my overhead, on my shingles, on my tiling roof, that echoing in my heart, and it gives birth thousands of fancies, and I was very busy to make these fancies. I was very busy to woove these fancies, to join these fancies together, and thousand recollections means thousand of past memories coming into my mind. I was thinking about the good past memories, and these all past memories are moving together. These all past memories are create so many fancies in my heart. And then what happened as I listened the patter of the rain upon the roof, means it is all happened while the poet is listening the pattering sound, the pitter patter sound of the raindrops falling on the roof. Means in this stanza the poet wants to say that when I was very busy and when I was very happy to lying on my chamber bed, and I was listening the pitter patter sound of the raindrops, thousands of memories, thousands of past memories again come into my mind, and they all are echoing together, and I recollect all these memories and make them as a woof. When we are using the thread on the loom, that makes a fiber. So in the same way, when so many thousands of past memory coming into my mind, they make a fabric, they make a collection. Okay, so what the past memories he was feeling, just look at the next stanza. See, this is the last stanza. Now in the memory comes my mother, as she used in the years ago to regard the darling dreamers, and she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel here found, look on me as I listen to this refrain which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Wow, very good words are used by this in this stanza. See, agone means what? Ago. Sometimes ago we are saying that na, ago means the past memories. And air क्या होता है? Air is ये जो words थे ये old poetries में use किए जाते थे to give them बोलते ना सजाना, किसी चीज़ को बहुत अच्छे से हम decorate करते हैं, तो to decorate the poetry these types of words are used. एक और word इसमें use किया गया decoration word, that is list. दोनों का meaning क्या होता है? Air का meaning होता है before, era, है ना? And list का meaning है listen. Refrain means sound of rain and patter means a poet sound of rain. So see in this stanza what the poet wants to say, that the poet says that these thoughts, these thousands of memories which are coming into my mind after listening the pattering sound of the rain which is falling on his shingles, on his tiling roof, so the memories of his dead mother which is no more there with him, so the memories which comes in his mind was his dead mother, and he remembers how she loved the poet while they are sleeping and dreaming at night. She fondly them softly until morning before leaving them to do her daily course. It is saying those past memories are of my mother's memories, because she was very cared and she was with him till the dawn. Means she fondly them softly until morning before leaving them to do to do her daily course. The poet still feels as if she is still looking at him. Means now he is feeling the presence of his mother, and he is saying by this, the poet still feels as if she is still looking at him fondly while he is listening the pitter patter raindrop falling on the roof. Means those memories was his dead mother memories, and he was talking about his mother by saying that she was very loved mother, and now after listening the pitter patter sound of the rain, I feel that my mother is now also with me. And this is the up to the poem, and it's a very good poem. Words chosen was very good. So let us see now the figure of speech in the first stanza. The figure of speech first is alliteration is used here. What's the alliteration means? The repeated sound of consonant sound. See, humid, hover, her sound is there. Now starry, sphere, S sound is there. Now see again, cottage, chamber, K sound is there. So first of all, the alliteration is used in so many lines. And then second is onomatopoeia. What is the meaning of onomatopoeia? This is the figure of a speech which is used to using the sound words. Like patter word is a sound word. It's not a dictionary word. It's only a sound word. Tip tip sound is there of the raindrop. That is called a pattering sound. So when the patter sound, any sound word is used, that is called onomatopoeia. And third figure of speech which is used in this, that is personification. Like here, the poet is used rainy tears. Actually, the clouds are denoting as a human being, and these raindrops are denoting as a tears. So when a non-living thing is personified as a living thing, when the non-living thing is just like a बोलते हैं ना जब नॉन लिविंग थिंग को एक लिविंग थिंग के कैरेक्टर्स दे दिए जाते हैं दैट इज कॉल्ड पर्सोनिफिकेशन एज यू ऑल नो दैट क्लाउड्स वोंट गिव एनी क्लाउड वोंट फॉल एनी टीयर्स बट हियर द क्लाउड्स आर कंपेयर्ड विद द ह्यूमन बीइंग एंड द रेन ड्रॉप्स आर द रेनी टीयर्स सो दीज थ्री फिगर ऑफ स्पीच आर यूज इन दिस फर्स्ट स्टेंजा इन द सेकेंड स्टेंजा ऑल्सो alliteration is there. Just find out where is the alliteration in the second stanza and which other figure of speech in the second and third stanza. Just find out by yourself. So write down the summary of this poetry. I hope you have understood the poetry meaning. So it's up to you. Goodbye. Take care.